I run an organization by the name GoAyush.com. The company's name is Ayush Global Private Limited. GoAyush.com is basically a marketplace for herbal, natural, organic goods, where we have a good number of manufacturers across the country who directly host and display their products on our marketplace for sale to customers, the end customers directly. So there are no layers in between of say wholesalers or distributors or even retailers, and the packet actually reaches right directly from the manufacturer's go down to the customer. So this is the uniqueness that we follow. We follow a zero inventory model, so just to keep our costs low and to keep the expiry dates in check, the prices in check, as well as the fraudulence also in check. So this helps us in that way. Customer experience, if I were to talk about what kind of a role it has to play in our organization and in our line of business, let me share that yes, we have the biggest of marketplaces as our competitors today in India. To name a few, Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal, everybody hosts a good range of such products. Then there are exclusive beauty marketplaces like Nykaa and other things. We have to compete against these people. Now, the only thing that we know is that if we are not providing some kind of a better value than them to our end customers, then we can't survive. So, obviously, customer experience, the benchmark for customer experience for the end customers has been already set by these big wigs. The kind of feel, the experience that they have while making their purchases at Amazon and Flipkart. If they don't get anything better than that, the customers will never come to our marketplace. So I think that is the kind of importance that customer experience has for our organization. Now, if we were to talk about CX strategy, I would rather use a term called, say, CX focus. Dynamic landscape that we are operating in, where technology and the customer expectations, all these are actually undergoing a lot of change very dynamically. In fact, there's a regular upgradation which is going on in these fields. So the prime effort from our side is to keep ourselves updated as to what all is the customer now experiencing at other places, in other sites, and what are the customer expectations in this changing world where technology is also playing such an important role. So the biggest challenge that we feel right now is that for us to decide as to what to adopt and what to postpone in adopting, say like AI and chatbots, even though we have not gone for chatbots as of today as a part of our CX and our customer feedback and customer response system. But yes, we are still analyzing, and that is basically a conscious decision. So these are strategies which are important from the standpoint of the customer's experience, and which actually directly translate into numbers and customer engagement. So if I were to say that yes, by having not gone in for chatbot, by having my own old feedback system and the customer response system in place, if I have not if I have been able to retain my customers well and attract newer customers, I think it is working well for me. So probably that is the benchmark that I would like to go with. That if at all the numbers are not dwindling, if the numbers are growing as per what we would expect them to be growing, then our CX strategy is working. But the other side to it is that yes, we have to keep our eyes and ears open to what the world is now experiencing. Because it's in this fast changing world, the customer expectations also change very dramatically and very fast. We also need to keep ourselves updated on that. I think that's what it is. If we were to talk about, say, identifying the kind of problems that our CX strategy would lead to or is facing over a period of time, we have to, like just like any other business, we have to be very vigilant about the stage-wise funnel numbers that we have for customers. Say, how many number of people are visiting our website, from there, which website are from where are they being led to our website? Is it through Google search or is it through our promotions? or is it through some other means? This is what we have to actually be very vigilant for. This is so far as our customers are coming in. Now, once the customer has actually landed on any of our pages, what kind of time is he spending on, what kind of product pages and things like this? What kind of cart abandonment are we facing? What kind of queries are we facing? What kind of numbers of queries are there? Are we able to solve those queries for the customers before the purchase decisions are made? Now, these are things, stage-wise funnels, stage-wise numbers are to be monitored regularly. We do that. And whenever we find something adverse happening in any of those funnels, we get an indication that yes, this is where somewhere, probably we are faltering. Say, if at all, we have people who are, in fact, there's a good number of carts we have, abandoned carts we have, and then there are, good number of payment gateway failures. We immediately get to know that yes, this is some kind of, order placing issue. So we need to address that immediately. So because once a customer is gone, he's gone forever. This is what we, the premise we would like to follow. So we would wish for a zero abandonment and zero customer detachment, if I were to call it. If you were to talk about, say, proactive CX strategies that we have employed in the recent past, immediately could we talk about, I think two come to mind if I were to talk about. One is that we've actually started a 24/7 helpline, a manual helpline, where there's a person who will pick up the phone whenever the phone comes in from the customer at any, at any part of the day, at any time of the day. And this person is actually equipped with a fairly decent amount of knowledge about how things work in our company, what we offer, and the kind of products that are being offered. So the kind of questions that we generally saw that we face at the time of purchase making decisions from the customer's end were more to do with, say, something to do with the products, something to do with, sometimes it was also to do with how to place an order, the order is not being placed, not getting placed, and things like these. So the person who's actually at this end of the call from our side is equipped to handle such queries. We've made sure that yes, we have a decent level person who's attending these calls 24/7. This has really helped us, I can say this. And because the number of orders at the odd times of the day has actually increased. This is a direct evidence of that yes, this worked. The other strategy if I were to talk about was that we have now started for customers who have specific queries about certain products, we have now started getting a call to them directly from the manufacturer's research desk. This has really helped them in clarifying all their doubts regarding the various products that are offered on our website. And from the with that interaction with the manufacturer's research people directly, the customer's confidence in the product and in us has also, catapulted to a large extent. It has really given us good results, returns over a period of time. And I really am proud that we could actually manage to start this. And this has really proven useful for us. So far as the impact of, the CX strategies that we try to involve, try to introduce in our lines of business is concerned, I'm really happy to share that by actually adding those two, especially the 24/7 helpline as well as direct call from the manufacturer for resolution of all queries related to the product. Now, especially the second one, this one actually has helped us differentiate our portal from the bigger marketplaces who also host these kind of products. This is where initiative. Probably that the credibility of our brand in the has actually gone up, and the customer now perceives, especially the regular customers now, they really perceive us as somebody who's a specialist of this line rather than just a marketplace of all.